Live. Our number is 248-416-1300. We also have a 24-hour webcast on abnsat.com. It's a Jesus or Muhammad English apologetics webcast, so make sure you check that out. That's abnsat.com. We have to take a break. You're watching ABN Live. Stay tuned.
If you are a user on Facebook, ABN would be happy to add you as a friend. Simply search ABN Sat and add us as a friend. After doing so, send and we will approve your request. ABN loves to add new members, so find us and we hope to see you soon.
Pastor Barbara Yandel, I want to invite you to join us to an exciting new series called Women and Islam. Look for details on abnsat.com.
Live debate. James White. Osama Abdullah. Sam Shamoon. Farhan Qureshi, David Wood, Sheikh Awal, Tony Costa, Kamal Salim, Jesus of Muhammad. Live debate.
On the Jesus or Muhammad Marathon, we have a debate going on. We have another debate at 11 p.m. tonight between Tony Costa and Farhan Qureshi, so make sure you stay tuned for that. At this time, we're going to take your calls. We're live in the studio, and our first caller is Dr. Imad. Welcome to the show, Dr. Imad. Who is your question geared to tonight?
Yes. Thank you so much for this debate. For this terrific program, Al Aramaya, do it, ABN. Thank you, Tony, for raising very important point. Unfortunately, Mr. Osama tried to answer, but he failed. Okay. First, Mr. Osama, I will speak only maybe maximum 2 minutes. First point, Muhammad was in doubt. Is this angel of God or this is devil? According to Halabiya, according to Al-Buti, Fiqh al-Sira, Muhammad was in doubt. Khadija tested this issue with very, very naive test. She started to take part of her clothes off and kiss Muhammad. And then the revelation, spiritual being disappeared. So she told him, congratulations, Muhammad. This proves that this spiritual being is angel, whose shame was shy from this partially naked woman. Of course, this is according to Ibn Hisham, taken from Ibn Ishaq, Juz al-Awwal, Volume 1, and all 10 most topic Muslim ancient and contemporary scholars. Muhammad said, I was ordered by God to fight all people until they say, no God but Allah, and I am his prophet. And anyone renounced Islam should be killed. Be proud of your prophet Osama, who forced people to be a Muslim. If anyone renounced his religion, should be killed. Arredda, Islamic Sharia law. As happened after death of Muhammad, 70% of Arabs renounced Islam, and then war of apostasy waged 7 months against them from the first successor. Be proud of your prophet Muhammad, Mr. Osama, who ordered the husband to beat his wife. What a prophet, and what a very good family value.
Dr. Ahmed, what is your question Surah, for Osama?
Surah, verse 34, beat your wife.
Dr. Ahmed, do you have a specific question for Osama? Because we have a lot of calls coming in. We want to give opportunity for as many people as possible, and we have less than 25 minutes left on the show.
Why Muhammad, 2 questions. Why Muhammad told his disciples, according to the Mukhsari Kashaf, Volume 1, hang the whip so your wives can see it? Second question, why Muhammad's disciple immediately after his death starting to fight, competing for leadership. And a few years later, in ثقيفة بني ساعدة, few years later, his favorite wife, Aisha, waged a war against his favorite cousin in battle of Camel, trying to kill his cousin. Is he a prophet of God? After his death, disciple killed one another. Answer, Mr. Muhammad.
Okay.
Sister Osama.
Osama, did you hear the questions? Osama, are you with us? Did you hear Dr. Ahmad's questions for you?
Can you guys hear me? Hello?
Yeah, yes. Did you hear Dr. Ahmad's
two questions? This is biased. This is ridiculous. This guy went on ranting forever. He threw 100 questions to me, okay? So I want to answer every one of them, if I may.
Okay, why don't you answer a couple of them so that we can allow other people to call into the show?
Okay,
he had two main questions towards the end.
Okay, first of all, Second Book of Chronicles, chapter 15, verse 13, it says, all who would not seek the Lord, the God of Israel, were put to death, whether small or great, man or woman. So jihad started, you know, fighting for the cause of God Almighty, the infidels, the idol worshippers, okay, which your Bible praises in the Isaiah 42 verses that I gave. You know, he will crush the idols. He will come from Mecca and Medina, okay, and he will be the light and the shine the light in Arabia and etc. All this is referring to Muhammad. But, you know, in the second book of Chronicles, chapter 15, it talks about those who did not worship God Almighty, the God of Israel, were put to death, okay? So put up or shut up, okay? Accept your Bible or be quiet. And now as to Khadija and all that, these narrations are proven to be false, you know, took off her clothes and all that. And as to, I don't know, what other questions he asked? He asked about... What else did he ask about?
He asked a lot of questions. That's fine. You answered one of his questions.
Okay, but you know what, ma'am? I have a problem with you, okay? One question per person, okay? Please. We can't have people ranting left and right. I'm debating Mr. Tony here, not everybody.
That's fine. You just need to calm down so that we could at least allow the callers to call in. We'll keep it one question per caller, and if you had listened a little carefully, you would have heard that I had cut him off so that he could only ask you one or two questions. That's fine, though. We understand. Again, our lines are 248-416-1300. We have about 20 minutes left on the show. If you don't get through to this program, stay tuned at 11 p.m. Tony will be back. Hopefully you will, too. Again, our lines are 248-416-1300. Again, we ask that if you do call and specify who the question is for, try to keep it short and try to keep it to one question so that we can allow more people to call in. Who do we have with us now on the line? Welcome to the show. You're live with Jesus or Muhammad. Who do we have on the line with us?
Hello?
Hi, do we have Thomas on air with us? Welcome to the show.
All right, hey, I'm Kabane, the Christian from YouTube, for those who may recognize me. I have a question for Mr. Abdullah about quotations from the prophet Isaiah and the Gospel of John. And in the prophet Isaiah, the Lord Yahweh says, I am he, the one who is speaking. That's chapter 52, verse 6. Mm-hmm. In the Gospel of John, Jesus Christ says, I am the one who is speaking. That's John chapter 4, verse 26. As you can see, Jesus actually directly quotes the prophet Isaiah, directly quotes the Lord Yahweh, and applies Yahweh's statement to himself. Now, in addition to this, and this is going to be my last point, I'm just going to try to be concise. In addition to this, in John chapter 1, it says, in the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. We have to look to the Old Testament to see who this Word was. In Genesis chapter 15, verses 1 through 2, it says, after these things, the Word of Yahweh came to Abram in a vision. Fear not, Abram, I am your shield, your rewards will be very great. But Abram said, O Lord Yahweh. So we can see the Word of Yahweh is actually Yahweh himself, as demonstrated in John chapter 1, Genesis chapter 15, and Isaiah chapter 52. John chapter 4. So I'd just like Mr. Abdullah to explain how these statements fit in with this contention that Jesus is not God, but the created being.
Okay, stay on the line, Thomas. I just want to make sure Osama is with us and he heard everything that you were saying. Osama, are you with us?
Yes.
Okay,
hello?
did you hear Thomas's question for you?
Yeah, no, I got it.
Okay, thank you, Thomas. We appreciate it. Go ahead, Osama.
Yes, thank you, Thomas. Well, first of all, John chapter 3, verse 28 for Mr. Tony. Okay, the same word, the I am, was translated as I have been and I have. Okay, John chapter 3, verse 28. Okay, I'm responding to his I am point. As to Thomas, Brother Thomas here, the prophets, they speak the words of God Almighty. Jesus received revelation. So when the Old Testament prophesies or speaks of God Almighty saying, I will speak or I am or something, and Jesus says the same word, It's Jesus quoting God Almighty or Jesus speaking the revelations of God Almighty. And also, don't forget, in the Bible, New Testament, Jesus said, I am the Father are one, and we are all one in the Father. Okay?